At this time, we have room 27. They're in science. Room 27 is Mr. Anthony Johnson's homeroom. The students will come forward and give their opinion of their time spent at the Garvey Academy. And the first lovely gentleman that I have at this time is Jermaine Atkins. Come on, Jermaine. Come and speak to the people. Come and tell us how the Garvey Academy has impacted you.
Impacted me by helping me with my work and to keep me out of trouble and things like that.
And how has your family been a support to you? Your sister? I think I met your cousin on yesterday.
Yeah. They helped me to...
One moment. Excuse me, young gentleman. This is something that 27 has been known to do. Be out of order on occasion. Jethro Bodine, sit at the other table, dear. All right. Now, continue, Jermaine.
They have helped me, like keeping me out of trouble and trying to make me do better on my work and stuff. But
where have you been accepted to your high school?
Nowhere.
Where?
I ain't get no lunch back.
Okay, where do you want to attend, though?
Osborne.
Okay, fine. We thank you so much. All right, next we'd like to hear from our own Andre Malone. Andre Malone. Andre Joseph Malone. He's one of the drummers out of the Marcus Garvey Traditional Drum and Dance Ensemble. I believe he plays third djembe. Come right up, Andre Joseph, and tell us about your experience here at the Garvey Academy.
Garvey has experienced me in learning about my past and teaching me things that I need to know to go into the future.
Have you traveled while you were at Garvey Academy?
Yes.
How so?
I went to the Bahamas with the drum and dance choir ensemble.
What did you learn there?
I learned that the people there, they look like us but talk different. They're very nice and they have their own stores and businesses to try to get money.
Okay. What did you eat while you were there? Anything you want to share with us?
We had the kind of rice, kind of spicy rice, and
can you give a special shout out to Mr. Hamburg at this time, a special show of thanks and appreciation, because we know without Mr. Hamburg, we wouldn't have been able to travel. What do you have to say, especially to the principal?
I want to say thank you for accepting me into Marcus Garvey, and I appreciate it.
All right, fine, and we thank you, dear. Asante. We would like to hear from the next student, Mr. Terrell Miley. Terrell is a businessman. He works at the party store for his mom and his stepdad. He has been someone who has shown excellence in business. Quickly coming, Terrell, dear. This is live. Yes, dear. Terrell Miley, how has the Garvey Academy impacted you, dear?
It impacted me, showing me about my history and all that. And showing me to be a better person, that's all I got to say.
Showing you how to be a better person. How mm-hmm. so? You were a bad person at one time?
Nah, yeah, in elementary.
In elementary, we used to tear you up, didn't we?
Not really?
Yeah. Well, we will tear you up, won't we?
Yeah.
All right, then. Thank you, dear. Next, we want to hear from our own Raymond, Deshaun, Didi. Come on. Quickly coming. I don't have time now. Quickly coming. Raymond has been with this group of young gentlemen since about the fifth grade. They were together since fifth grade. He is also very active in the manhood. As you can hear, some of the disrespectful ones in 27 hollering out loud. We don't appreciate it. All right, Raymond, how has Garvey Academy impacted your life?
It helped me where I can learn about my history and my culture and where my ancestors came from.
Okay. You're also a help to Shamari Matthews, who is over the manhood. How do you assist him?
I help with the younger students. I help also with both eighth grade classes, teaching them the things that they need to know for manhood.
Okay. Well, what things do they need to know for manhood?
They need to know the ritual agenda, the code of Ma'at, and the Nguzu Sabas.
All right. What is the code of Ma'at?
The code of Ma'at is the seven principles The Nguzu Sab is also the seven principles of blackness.
Okay, fine. And where have you been accepted to high school?
I'm going to Finney temporarily until I pull up my grades, and then I'm going to King.
All right, then. Well, we thank you very much. We thank you for all that you've done at the school. Asante Sana. All right. Next, we would like to hear from our own Zachary. Come on, Zachary. Quickly coming. You're going to have to take that jacket off because that's not a part of the uniform. I only want a part of the uniform. Okay, he's not ready. So we'll hear from Frank Williams. Frank Williams comes from a line of scholars. As you can hear from the background, many of the people in 27 have not matured, especially Lamont. He has not matured. Jethro Bodine, also Jahan, has not matured as they holler out. But here we have someone up here, Frank Williams. He comes from a line of scholars, a line of scholars. Your brother, what was your brother's name?
Mark Williams.
Yeah, Mark Williams, who's doing very well at?
Marcus Garvey Academy.
No, Mark went where to school?
To Cass.
He went to Cass. Where do you plan to go?
Cass.
You're going to Cass. You've already been accepted?
Yes.
All right, fine. How has the Marcus Garvey Academy impacted your life?
It helped me to learn about my ancestors.
Okay, and what else?
And about ancestral background.
Okay, what's that grade point average that you're holding currently?
3.8.
I would imagine that you've been contacted by a bunch of high schools. Is that true?
Yes.
All right, and you chose to go to Cass. What would you like to say to your parents, your mother and your dad, and your sisters and your brothers? I know you're a very close family.
I'm going to